with coronavirus, far fewer people can afford or want to take traditional vacations that require getting on jets and flying places. But RV vacations are up 1,600%. In this video, I'm going to show you an awesome workout you can do on an RV. Now, I have plenty of workout videos for travel, but they are tailored toward jet aircraft where you can only take light things in your carry-on luggage, like resistance bands and suspension trainers. But in an RV, you have a lot more options. Let's start with cardio. You can bring your bike when you're in an RV. You can put it in a rack on the trailer hitch, or if you don't have that, you can put it on the bed. But please put a sleeping bag down so you don't get grease all over the RV. Okay, so let's look at the equipment I brought. It's all in this compartment. First, we have our resistance bands, suspension trainer, dumbbell handles, weight plates. So I have 130 pounds of plates, resistance bands, suspension trainer. Now with a suspension trainer, you're gonna be tempted to use a ladder that virtually every RV has as a suspension point for your TRX. Don't do it. I guarantee you, you'll rip this right off the RV. This is fiberglass, it's not that strong. Do not put the TRX anywhere on the RV. Use a tree. Okay, let's start the workout. I'm gonna start with the suspension trainer because it's my favorite exercise. This is an awesome exercise for lats, for biceps, for upper back, and it feels great. So I've got this anchored in a tree about 6 to 7 feet high. I'm using very slow form. Now, if you want to make this harder, you can put a 25-pound plate on your chest, or two 25-pound plates, as you've seen me do before. If you want to make it easier, you can get a little further away from the tree, and that makes it easier. But this is an awesome exercise. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is another big exercise. I'm going to go over and do dumbbell flies. Now, if for some reason you don't have dumbbells with you, that's fine. Do push-ups. That's a great alternative. I am going to go ahead and do the dumbbell flies here. You could also do dumbbell press if you want, or you could do them both. You could do a drop set. What you're going to see here is that I use interesting form. You'll notice I don't go all the way down and I go very slowly. I have found that this is a great way to get 99% of the benefit with only 10% of the wear and tear on the shoulders. So this exercise feels awesome. And I'm going to use these dumbbells for a number of things in this workout, but this is the primary exercise I'm using them for, is the dumbbell fly. Now, all these exercises I'm showing you, I'm going to do in a round robin superset. No rest between them, I just go from one exercise to the next. So I did lats with the low rows, I did press, for the chest. Now I'm doing side raise with the band for shoulders. Now I could have used a dumbbell, but that's too much time adjusting the weights. I'll do those later, you'll see. So I'm going to do another, the side raise with the left arm. Again, I have found that a low range of motion gives you 99% of the benefit with only 10% of the wear and tear on the shoulders. Next exercise, I'm going to do curls using a band. Now, if you use the same weight on your chest as you do on curls, then you could use the dumbbells here. But I do a lot more on the dumbbell flies than I do on the curls. Next up, I'm doing hamstrings. This is a single-legged, stiff-legged deadlift. And one thing I'm finding here is something I should have known, is that this is soft, spongy ground. And it's a lot harder to balance on soft, spongy ground. It's actually great practice for your stabilizers. But I'm used to doing this on a solid mat. And doing it on spongy ground is much harder. Now, this is an awesome exercise for your hamstrings, but even more importantly, it's an awesome core exercise. Because you're doing this asymmetrically, it really works your lower back and core. So for people like me who have lower back issues, this is an awesome exercise to do. So let's recap. So I've done the TRX low rows for lats. I've done the dumbbell flies for chest. I've done the side raise with the band. I've done the curls with the band. And now I've done hamstrings. The next exercise I'm going to do is to go back to lats. I am going to do the dumbbell pullover. I absolutely love this exercise. And it's one that most people don't do, but when you do it, you will see how delicious this feels, and you will incorporate it into your workout. Now, I'm actually doing this workout on a rug that is typically found in every RV, even if it's a rental, along with a table and other things for camping. And this makes a great workout mat. So, now that I'm almost done with my lats, I'm going to rearrange the dumbbells and do a really light weight for shoulders. Now, I did a very similar exercise with the bands, but this hits it just a little bit differently. And I love the way this feels. You can flex your traps when you do this and work more traps than shoulders. You can vary how you work it. Now I'm going to do a front raise with the arms straight. This feels good. It's a little upper chest and shoulders, a great all-around shoulder upper body exercise. So if you haven't considered taking an RV vacation, you might want to do it. It's a great alternative to a traditional jet airplane and hotel kind of vacation. You can rent an RV in your local area and take it to wherever you want. And best of all, you can be completely safe. You're not changing hotel rooms. You're not in and out of restaurants where people may or may not be using masks. And you can work out and have awesome workouts. So that's it, my RV workout. Thanks for watching. Outfeeder Zane.